You'll need to use an account to manage Pi that has sufficient privileges. You could, of course, use the administrator account in Windows, but any account that has sufficient privileges will do. Whatever you choose, we do suggest that you consistently use that same account for all of your management. So if you're not going to be able to use administrator, better not, you know, best not to install with administrator if you're not going to be using that ultimately. So you're going to need privileges to do certain things, for example, being able to install and then start and stop system services, being able to modify the registry, create directories, copy files, those types of privileges. So you'll need an account that has those privileges. Now, with regard to the installation itself, you do have to make sure before you do the installation, you check the time and the time zone. Very, very important. Pi is a very time-sensitive application. So let me show you. If I go into Control Panel, you need to go into Date and Time. And make sure not only is your date and time set correctly, but your time zone needs to be set correctly. You see, Pi stores things as Coordinated Standard Time, the so-called Greenwich Standard Time. In the archive, we're storing everything using that standard time. So in order for us to do that, we really need to know what time zone we're in, so we will know what conversion to apply to the current time. So the time has to be correct, the time zone has to be correct. Be very careful you don't, on a Pi server, ever change the time, the system time, accidentally. Of course, Pi is again very sensitive to time. If you were to do something like set the time forward or backward, it creates a lot of problems as we try to write data to the archive that's got the wrong timestamp. Now, finally, in addition to the standard setup kit, you are going to have to download the license file for your particular server. So that's something, if you're not familiar with it, please contact our tech support. Technical support can send you that license file if you don't already have one. That basically turns on all the correct features for your particular licensing.